Okay, I think we have all the bathrooms clear, so we're ready to go with the second half. And our first act here is entitled Synchronized Swimmers. But as you know, we've had to make some substitutes in the show. And actually, we had the real U.S. Olympic team synchronized swimmers coming here to perform for you. But 3 days ago, they had to call and cancel. But luckily, the Pea Ridge Senior Swim Club jumped in to fill in. Now, you have to remember that they only had about 2 days worth of practice to do this. We also noticed that some of the people from Pea Ridge seemed to have a small problem differentiating between their left and their right. So you have to give them some slack. Here they are, the Pea Ridge Senior Swim Club. Let me say that again. Here they are. The Pea Ridge Senior Swim Club. Pea Ridge's finest. All right, audience, we have some medals here. What do you say? Should we give them the medals? The biggest thing that ever happened to P. Ridge, he'll not ever stop talking about this. Now as the water leaves us. Our next song is from the smash hit musical Chicago, which is the second longest running Broadway show in history. And Frank did such a great job on Mr. Cellophane back in our 2006 show, we just had to bring him back and it for you tonight. Take it away, Frank.
Someone stood up in a crowd, raised their voice up way out loud, and swayed around and shook a leg. You'd notice that. If someone in a movie show yells fire in the second row, this whole place is a fire pit. You'd notice that. Inconsequential. Suppose you was a little cat residing in a person's flat that fed you fish and scratched your ears. You'd notice them. Suppose you was a woman wed, lived in a double bed beside one man for 7 years. You'd notice him, made of more than air. With all this bunk you bound. Undistinguished, you know who. Should have been my name, Mr. Cellophane, 'cause you can look right through me, walk right by. Walk right by me. I never know I'm there. I hope I haven't taken up too much of your time.
Alright, great job, Frank. In the 2012 Follies, Carolyn sang Don't Tell Mama, and she's back with it again. It's a story about a dance line girl who the whole family knows about, except for Mama. Mama don't know. Alright, Carolyn, tell us the story.
Mama thinks I'm living in a convent, a secluded little convent in the southern part of in a nightclub, in a really short dress. So please, sir, you ran into my mama. Don't reveal my indiscretion. Give a working girl a chance. I shout, I don't tell mama. Shy shout, I don't tell mama. I don't tell mama. Whatever you do. If you had a secret, you bet I would keep it. I would never tell on you. I broke every promise that I gave her. So won't you go and do a girl a great big favor? So let's trust one another. Keep this from my mother, the one still as pure as hell. So you tell my papa that's all right, because he comes in here every night. Just sleep well enough alone. I don't show, I don't tell, I show, I don't tell mama, I don't tell mama, whatever you do. If you had a secret, you bet I would keep it, I would never tell on you. You wouldn't want to get me in a pickle and have to go and cut me off without.
I kind of think Mama knows what's going on anyway. Okay, this next number, Hot Diggity, Nancy was supposed to do, but she's in rehab. She's the one who fell and broke her hip. So Danielle has stepped in. And they're going to revive, with Ernie, she's going to relive our 2008 show with Perry Como's number one hit, Hot Diggity, a lively little number that, by the way, the backup lyrics on that song were by the Ray Charles Singers. Let's listen to them.
Yeah.
Danielle did a pretty good job there. She just flew in from Houston 2 days ago, and she told me she didn't even like mustard. All right, now it is story time. And here's one of Rhyme and Wit, composed by myself. Oh, we're missing our characters. Oh, we have our characters. Okay, so now we can have story time. And it's a story of two gals and one guy. A soap opera of sorts, and now let me explain why. First, there were two, a husband and a wife, the king and his queen for most of their life. He called her Edith, and she called her Stan. She was his queen, and he was her man. The king could smile, but the queen, she could not, because the child they both wanted, they couldn't be got. Well, the king was very able, being well made. It was the queen who was sterile as a spade. The king yearned for a son to carry his name, and soon it was Edith that he started to blame. The fighting, the yelling, Edith could take it no more. She called Stan a bum and his mistress a bad person. Well, Edith knew his mistress named Kate, a lovely lass, with a face like an angel and a firm, shapely ankle. She had nice ankles. The Kingston Trio, they became to be known, but a king with two queens was really rocking the throne. You see, lust and greed don't mix well with fate, and soon it was Edith who was lusting for Kate. You know, Stan, he still wanted to play, but the two queens in love just sent him away. But King Stan was persistent. He so yearned to play that he snuck back one time when Kate was away. But Edith resisted. She yelled. She hissed, which only made the king royally upset. Then Kate returned, much to Edith's delight, and old King Stan was nowhere in sight. So the two queens in love were quite happy and gay. And poor Stan, the king, he just couldn't have it his way. So what's the moral of this little story, this tale of rural scandal and glory? Well, I told Stan the moral, and now I'll tell you. Remember this, you can't have your Kate and Edith too. Okay. Frank Sinatra, Louis Armstrong, Rod Stewart, Willie Nelson, what do they all have in common? They all sang different genres for this next song. And from our 2013 Follies, our own Fred now offers his personal version. Now Fred is, we think he's the oldest member of the cast, but we're not sure because the ladies all lie about their age anyway. So here's Fred with Sunny Side of the Street.
If I never had a cent, I'd be rich as Richard Rockefeller. Gold dust at my feet on that sunny to a woman in your shade with the blue on the rain. Oh, no, I'm not afraid to throw her across over. If I never had a cent, I'd be rich as Rockefeller with gold dust at my feet on that sunny, on that sunny, sunny, on that sunny side of the street. Oh, yeah.
Hey, not bad for an old man, is it? Earlier we enjoyed Mr. Cellophane from the musical Chicago. And Bob from our 2006 Follies show brings us another song from that same musical, All I Care About Is Love. Here's Bob.
Let me see her standing there. Honestly, mister, I'm a millionaire.
Sexes has been going on since the cave age time. And tonight, to prove once again that a husband can never, ever be right, Nancy brings back her comical 2013 performance, and this time with Jim Bob. Let's listen in as this age-old battle of the sexes continues. Yes?
If I should die, would you get married again?
Oh, definitely not. Definitely not.
I thought you'd like being married.
Well, of course I do. Getting married with you is a pure delight.
Why wouldn't you get married again?
Oh, boy, here we go again. Okay. I'd get married again.
You would?
Oh. Yes.
Are you going to live in our house with her?
Well, it's a good house. It's paid for and the taxes aren't too bad. Yeah, I think so. Sure, it's a great house.
Are you going to sleep in our bed with her?
Jeez. Well, you know, we just got it recently, and it's one of those number beds. You can set it up to however a person likes it. So, yeah, probably. Where else would we sleep?
You want to let her drive our car?
Oh, jeez.
My car?
Yeah, it's a new car. It's almost new, so probably. She'd probably drive it.
Are you going to move my picture down and put hers in the house?
Let me think. Yes, that seems like it would be the proper thing to do.
You going to let her wear my jewelry?
Oh, dear. Well, you know what? I think most women like to have their own jewelry, so probably not. She'd probably want her own.
Well, I know you like to go golfing and we had good times together. Are you going to take her with you this time?
Yes, those were good times. They were good times, so I'd probably take her, yes.
Well, if you take her golfing, are you going to let her use my golf clubs?
Of course not. She's left-handed.
If you just kept his mouth shut. All right, coming up next, Nat King Cole sang this song in 1950, and his daughter Natalie Cole sang it in 1991. Now our own Vivian brings it to the back from the 2007 Follies, and she croons it again on our 2017 stage. Here's Vivian.
Wonderful, you are mine. I was humming a tune.
Okay. The Lady of Tramp is a spoof of New York high society from the musical Babes in Arms. Then later, Frank Sinatra made it his signature song from the film Pal Joey. Now here's Don and Tana back from our 2006 Follies shows to present it for you.
She gets too hungry for dinner at 8. She loves the theater, but never comes late. She never bothers with the people she hates. Whoa, that's why the lady is a tramp. Go to crap games with barons and earls. Oh, go to Harlem in ermine and pearls. She won't dish the dirt with the rest of the girls. That's why the lady is a tramp. She loves a refresh wind in her hair. Life without care. She's broke, but it's okay. She hates California. It's cold and it's damp. That's why the lady is a tramp. Oh, she gets too hungry for dinner at 8. She loves the theater, but never comes late. She never bothers with the people she hates. Oh, that's why the lady is a tramp. Don't like bad games with sharpies or frogs. Won't go to Harlem in Lincoln on board. Hey, she won't dish the dirt with the rest of the girls. That's why the lady is a tramp. She loves that free fresh wind in her hair. Life without care. She's broken, it's okay. She hates California. It's cold and it's damp. That's why the lady. That's why the lady. That's why my lady is a tramp.
Don't know about you, but you didn't look like a tramp to me. Okay, Andy Williams released the Hawaiian Wedding song, and it was followed by Elvis Presley, did it later with his own version. But I'm telling you, Elvis never showed the moves that our Jan and Sue are going to show you in just a second here. The girls, since this is Valentine's weekend, wanted to dedicate this dance to all you Valentine lovers out there. So enjoy.
Thank you.
All right. Happy Valentine's Day. The Shangri-Las recorded Leader of the Pack back in 1965, I believe. This describes a teenage motorcycle tragedy. Pat sang it in our 2013 show, and she's back again with it this afternoon for you. Here's the Pack. All right. You know, the Rat Pack, Dean Martin and Frank Sinatra and Sammy Davis and Joey Bishop, they ruled Vegas in the 60s and the 70s. Well, folks, let me tell you, we have our own Rat Pack right here. And they're going to sing a song from that era and from our 2013 Follies. They're back, the Rat Pack.
Drink to me only, that's all I ask, and I will drink to you. I don't care if the sun don't shine, I do my drinking in the evening time. Sit in the sunny camp. I get my colors from the sunray last when I'm in Las Vegas. I love the laugh, I love the life, there's fun of every night. Next time I come, I'll break my wine. I'll do that if I lose my mind. In Vegas, take my life,
yes, I love Vegas. May I say, it's a gasser. I love Vegas, like it's Egypt, and Alaska. I love Vegas every moment. I love Vegas because my money is here.
I love Vegas when I'm winning. Oh, I love it when I lose. I love Vegas like the
the door prizes. Dale and Muriel are going to show us some smooth waltz moves while dancing to Andy Williams' theme song, Moon River. Dance away, you two. Okay, I get the house lights up here for a minute.
It's what they've been waiting for the whole time, huh?
All right, we're going to give the baskets away.
All right, while they're getting ready backstage for the military salute, we're going to present some door prize baskets here, okay? Is everybody ready? All right.
I hope you remember which basket you're after. Number one goes to Reno?
Right.
Reno?
Yes,
oh, there
right.
He is. All right. Get it after the show. Come down and get it. Basket number one. Oh,
Frank and I graduated together in Newcastle, Pennsylvania.
Oh. 4,000 years ago. All right. Basket number two. Let's see. Who we got here? Richard. Is it Carrion? Richard Carrion? Oh, there he is. Okay, basket number two after the show. All right, basket three. I'm going to have to guess on this one. Shane Lehigh? Okay, after the show, basket, that was three, right? Okay, number four. This is the one. Has somebody paid me $30 to call their name on. And it was Ann. Is it Kirby? Ann Kirby? Up there. Oh, way up there. Okay. Number four after the show. Okay, this is basket six. Five. I'm just seeing if you were watching. Joanne Maxwell. Okay, Joanne. Five, huh? There's number five. All right, number six. All right, number six. We have B.C. Johnson. B.C. Johnson. Oh, right over there. Okay, you got it. Down here, basket seven. Don't give up though, after seven we still have two grand prizes. Okay, basket seven. Paul Herrick. H-E-R-R-I-C-K, Paul Herrick. Two times for Paul, three times. Sorry, Paul, you blew it. Travis Ficklin, is it? Travis Ficklin? Okay, Travis, you got number seven. Now what we're gonna do is we have two grand prizes down here. We're gonna take all the losing tickets and dump them into one box and pull out for the two grand prizes. In there? We got them all in there. Okay, first grand prize. Somebody put the wrong side. No name on it. You deserve to lose. Okay, let's see here. B.C. Johnson? Didn't we just have B.C. Johnson? How did that get in there? You can't have two. We did practice this, by the way. Okay, is it Dobby Mueller? Okay, you got the first grand prize. And the final prize, here we go. It is Kim Sullivan. Oh, Kim's way up there. Okay, Kim, you got the second grand prize. Does the one who put the wrong one in want to stand up and be recognized?
All right, I think they should be ready backstage, so we'll see if we can get this final salute to the military, and we want to thank you guys for coming today.
Well, before our salute here, I have a confession to make to you people. I lost the music to this next number. So our dancing ladies are going to have to tap dance without any music. My fault, sorry. We need the curtains open, no? They can't tap dance without the curtains open. Okay, no music. Sorry about that, ladies. Those who served in the military, serving currently or served in the past, can we get the audience lights up too? So, would all my fellow Marines stand and remain standing? All right. Set your side, baby. Okay, how about Navy personnel? We're going to remain standing. Remain standing. Navy personnel. How about Air Force? Yeah. Air Force. Yeah. The Wild Blue Yonder. And the Army. Yeah. Oh, some K-Sign. We got some K-Sign. All right. And the Coast Guard. How about the Coast Guard? All right, couple of Coast Guards. All right, thank you very much. Be seated.
Thank you less than you.
you have enjoyed our 20th anniversary Senior Follies show, and here is our 2017 Senior Follies cast, supported by stage manager Ashley Sarver, assisted by Keven and Joel. Our microphones are managed by Lois and Ken Peterson, and the lighting by Mark Peterson. The sound by Jeff Gordon. Makeup by Michael Tobias. Program production and background slides by Wayne Funk. The script by Karen and Ken Turk. The show is produced and directed by Ken Turk, and I'm Jim O'Connor, your MC. And now, as usual, we end it all with Young at Heart.